not for atomic energy, for none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets as we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. You got to fulfill the book. Won't you help me sing this song of freedom? All I ever had, redemption song.
Thank you. Jesus, it would be all right if he changed my name, changed my name. I told Jesus it would be all right if he changed my name, changed my name. I told Jesus it would be all right if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me that I'd have to live a humble if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me that I'd have to live a humble if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me that I'd have to live a humble if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me that the world would hate me if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me that the world would hate me if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me that the world would hate me if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me it would be all right if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me it would be all right if he changed my name, changed my name. Jesus told me it would be all right if he changed my name, changed my
Then they took Jesus from Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters. It was early in the morning. They themselves did not enter the headquarters so as to avoid ritual defilement and be able to eat the Passover. So Pilate went out to them.
What accusations do you bring against this man?
If this man were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you.
Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law.
We are not allowed to put anyone to death.
Are you king of the Jews?
Do you ask this on your own? Or did others tell you about me?
I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?
My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here.
So you are a king?
You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice.
What is truth?
After he had said this, he went out to the people again and said to them,
I find no case against him, but you have a custom that I release someone for you at the Passover. Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?
Not this.
No, not this man. Give us Barabbas. Give us Barabbas.
Give us Barabbas.
Holy Moses, I have been removed. I have seen the specter. He has been here too. Distant cousin from down the line, a brand of people, not my kind. Holy Moses, I have been removed. Holy Moses, I have been. The wind has changed direction. Now I've got to leave. Won't you please excuse my frankness? It's not my cup of tea.
Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. The soldiers dressed him in a purple robe. They wove a crown of thorns and put it on his head. They kept striking him in the face. Hail, King of the Jews.
There's a light in my life.
trust in Jesus, my balance will return. Don't you see there's light in my life shining on me? Lord, walk with me. Please talk to me. Stay close by my side. Be my comfort, be my guide. Yeah, I was blind, but now I see. Jesus came and he rescued me. There's a light in my life shining over me. There's a light in my life shining over me.
Pilate went out to the people again.
Tell me, what do you want me to do?
Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!
Take him yourselves and crucify him. I find no case against him.
We have a law, and according to that law, he ought to die because he has claimed to be the Son of God.
Now, when Pilate heard this, he was more afraid than ever. He entered into the headquarters again and asked Jesus,
"Where are you from?"
But Jesus gave him no answer.
"Do you refuse to speak to me? Do you not know that I have power to release you and power to crucify you?"
"You would have no power over me unless it had been given to you from above. Therefore, the one who handed me over to you is guilty of the greater sin."
Might be the brightest that you ever seen. that you have done. No hope for tomorrow in the setting of the sun. And the ocean is howling for the way things might have been. And that bright good morning sunlight might be the brightest that you ever seen.
From then on, Pilate tried to release him, but the people cried out,
"If you release this man, you are no friend of the emperor."
"Everyone who claims to be a king sets himself against the emperor."
When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus outside and sat on the judge's bench at a place called the stone pavement, or in Hebrew, Gabbatha. Now it was the day of preparation for the Passover, and it was about noon.
"Here is your king."
"Away with him!
Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him! Crucify him!
Shall I crucify your king?"
"We have no king but Caesar."
"Amazing grace will always be my song of praise. For it was grace that brought my liberty. I'll never know just how he came to love me so. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need. I shall forever lift my eyes to Calvary to view the cross where Jesus died for me. How marvelous the grace that caught my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need. I shall forever lift my eyes to Calvary, yeah, yeah, to view the cross where Jesus died for me. How marvelous the grace that caught my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need.
Then Pilate handed Jesus over to be crucified.
Jesus is convicted and taken from Caiaphas to Pilate, where a mob is gathered, thirsty for death. Some people watch the gathering scene from afar, others are close up, intent on seeing this so-called Messiah murdered. "Crucify him," they yell. "What accusation do you bring against this man?" asks Pilate. "What have you done?" he inquires of Jesus. Then, following an exchange between Pilate and a soldier, Pilate says, "Take him and flog him." Pilate washes his hands of the entire mess while soldiers take an innocent man who was lauded by jubilant crowds waving palms the week before, a man who has done no wrong. They dress him in a purple robe and weave a crown of thorns, placing it on his head. They strike him in the face. In Washington, D.C., a mob stands listening to Trump, who says, "You're the people who built this nation. You'll never take back our country with weakness. You have to be strong." And the crowd yells, "Hang Mike Pence! Hang Mike Pence!" "We will not let them silence your voices. Get your people to fight," Trump says. And the insurrectionists beat Brian Sicknick to death. An innocent man who got out of bed that morning, showered, dressed, and went to work to do a job the 42-year-old had performed for 12 years. And Trump washes his hands of the crowd he has incited, leaving the blood of death and destruction on them. The soldiers in Jerusalem make a charcoal fire and stand around it, warming themselves. Peter stands with them, warming himself. "You are also one of his disciples, aren't you?" he is asked. But Peter denies it. There is no fire at the Capitol building. But these insurrectionists will deny their culpability later. They will deny their plan to beat and perhaps murder elected public officials and anyone else who gets in the way. They will say, "I was only following my president. I was following my president's orders. He told me to do it." And so they break windows and call Metropolitan Police Officer Daniel Hodges a white nationalist before crushing him between a door jamb where he is caught writhing and screaming in pain. This is their country, their president has told them, as if no one else has a right to lay claim to this land. As if Harry Dunn, who lies gasping for breath on the Capitol floor in a building he has defended for years, lies gasping, looking at the blood on his hands while he's being called the N-word over and over, as if he has no right to question why this mob is beating him, no right to ask, "Is this America?" For many Americans around the world, January 6, 2021, was more than a Christian epiphany, revealing the first manifestation of Jesus. For folks in this country and folks around the world of every religion and of no religion at all, January 6, 2021 was a worldwide epiphany. One that peeled back a curtain of lies to reveal the compelling truth many of us, especially people of color across the face of the earth, have always known, but that others never took the time to see, the curiosity to know, or the energy to respond to. The truth that America is still a racist country, founded on the theft of land from a group of indigenous people who welcomed the new arrivals in friendship, and the theft of Africans who were dragged here in chains by those same new arrivals and forced to work themselves to death in hot tobacco, cotton, and rice fields, while the thieves who stole them became rich and strong and powerful and privileged. It is a truth that countries around the world and across the breadth of this planet also know about themselves. A truth of who they really are when it comes to their fellow human beings of color. Spiritual epiphanies often cause us to become privy to illuminating discoveries brought about through God's intervention. Discoveries that sometimes reveal a truth that can save us. Epiphanies that do not necessarily come from a spiritual awareness can do the same thing. Illuminate a discovery that can help us see a truth that is capable of saving us. What truth did January 6, 2021 reveal to us? What truth did that illuminating discovery help us see? What from that insurrection might save us? We are now 3 months past that epiphany, yet still watching innocent African American, Muslim, Latinx, Indigenous, immigrant, and Asian American brothers and sisters succumb to beatings and deaths. They, the insurrectionists, try to disrupt this country's democracy. That was their goal, Harry Dunn said, looking into a camera on an episode of Soul of a Nation. But y'all failed. He continued. Y'all failed because later that night they went on and they certified the election. What is our role in the aftermath of the January 6th insurrection? How do we go on? What do we certify? What is our role in what has become a racial reckoning in America? Will we move forward to certify that this country now has a better sense of what it means to accept the humanity of one another, to work for liberty and equality for all? Or will we continue to stand by and watch policemen shoot African-American men, women, and children in the backs? Watch thugs beat elderly Asian-Americans on the streets of our cities and mow down young ones inside a spa? Watch our government cage Latinx children at our borders, and goons desecrate the worship spaces of Jewish American brothers and sisters? Who among us, like Pilate and Trump, will wash our hands and deny what we know to be happening to our fellow citizens caught in the middle of this American betrayal, conviction, and execution? What is our role in our own Good Friday?
Spit it out. My saliva solidifies, spitting out solid speech. Spit it out. Spit it out. Spit it out. Spit this for square pegs that just don't fit. The ones who were laughed at, ridiculed, and told that they just weren't it. Spit it out. Spit it out. For those who experience inner city blues, for those of many hues that are considered the lesser, spit it out in the face of the oppressor. Spit it out. Spit it out. Spit it out. For those who chose to oppress, for those who are considered less. The voiceless, with limited choices, those who are in a crisis, spit it out, for those whose life is priceless, for those who are encaged and those who are enraged and those who are feel disengaged, spit it out. Spit it out. Find ways to get it out. For those who have been crucified and those who have been denied and those who have tried to overcome and who have overcame. Spit it out for those who have been called lame, those who have been ashamed, and those who are chose to oppose, those who have had their noses thumbed at. We become that, we are that, we be that. See, I just spit it out. Spit it out. Spit it out. For those who have doubted us, for those who have doubted the godliness in us, and for those who have not trusted, and even those who don't believe we are, still seeing, still spit it out. For the children, Spit it out. For those, the elders, who we care for, spit it out. For everyone, anyone, spit it out. Those incarcerated, spit it out. Those are violated, spit it out. Spit it out. Spit it out. Those in need of love, spit it out. Let it out. Be love. Be love. Be love. Ow!